Hello, I'm Dr. Anika Singhal. I'm 53 years old and I've done my MBBS from SCB Medical College, Cuttack. Then I did my DNB in my family medicine from Delhi. Had to look after my three patients, my mother, who was a patient of psychosis, and my father-in-law, who was insulin-dependent diabetics with multi-organ failure, and third was my mother-in-law, who is a patient of bronchial asthma, hypertension, and Washer's obsessive compulsive disorder. So now my mother and my father-in-law are no more, and I just have to look at present about my mother-in-law. So the things are much easier right now. Earlier I was working in the hospital, but due to the family circumstances, I could not continue my job in the hospital because every second day I needed a leave, and morning when I used to get up and get ready to go to the hospital, my mother or my father-in-law, you know, they used to fall down or some other problem used to have. It was very difficult for me to continue with the job. So ultimately I decided to leave the job and have my own clinic and do freelancing teaching. This decision had a negative impact on my career, definitely, because even in the clinic I could not be regular. For teaching also I could not be regular. And so that followed a financial problem. There were some emotional problems also. So I had a harrowing experience while taking care of my parents, emotionally, physically, and financially. You know, all three wise, the family life also suffered. But on the retrospective, when I think, I feel very contented that I could look after my parents the way I wish. So that was the life I chose. It was not forced on me. At one point of time, I was also under depression. I had to take medicines, antidepressants for 6 months I took. So because it was not easy. One psychotic patient, another OCD, hypertension, bronchial asthma, other diabetic with multi-organ, all three old people. So I decided to do something for me. I was always interested in photography. I went and bought my camera. It was a difficult decision to spend so much. I had never spent anything on myself. It was always my family, my parents, my children. So I decided to pick up my camera. I bought a camera. Then one of my friends used to do birding. And so I just decided to go once with them for a birding trip, and I really loved it. And so I then started pursuing birding as a hobby, and it was really a boon for me, that birding. Whenever I went for birding, I felt so much at peace and looking at the birds, and I was more closer to the nature. And this birding brought me close to more beautiful aspects of life, and also taught me lots of patience, which is required. I was losing patience taking care of my parents, and this birding gave me patience, which was really required. You know, when you are doing birding, you are calm. You have to keep quiet. So you get time to spend with yourself. That is very important. Number two, you learn patience. Number three, you are more near the nature. So I don't know how, but being near the nature always gives you more peace. So, and plus good birding, sighting good rare birds gives you an extra kick, and good photographs really make you happy. At first thing, have patience. In dealing with such chronically ill patient, you need to have lots of patience. That's very, very important. Number two, no matter what, you should be empathetic to the patient, to such patients. Because whatever they are doing, we sometimes feel they are doing on purpose. They are not doing on purpose. So, you know, they are also helpless. So we need to be empathetic to them. This condition can be on us also any day. Okay, so that we have to remember. The third thing is, it's okay to get frustrated or angry at times. You know, sometimes, you know, after taking care of such chronically ill patients, you do get frustrated, you do get angry. And sometimes you vent out anger at your patients or the people who you are taking care of. So it's okay. So don't feel guilty about it.